hallelujah to the Most High God. Father, we come to you today lifting up, blessing, and praising your holy name. We come to you today thanking you, Father, for all that you have done for us and all that you are going to do. We pray, Heavenly Father, for your traveling mercies for the people that are going to and fro. We pray you have traveling mercies for those that are on their way here to be in this meeting today. We pray, Heavenly Father, that you bless them and keep them safe from all hurt, harm, and danger as they're traveling. We pray, Heavenly Father, for the children of the world. We pray that you would keep them in your stead. We pray for our leaders. We pray for our pastors and all the members in a Pleasant Place. We pray that you would just lead us, teach us, and guide us in everything that our pastors have for us. May it come from you through them. In your precious Son, Jesus Christ's holy name, we pray and ask all things. Amen.
The song says, I praise your name, your holy name. I praise your name, your holy name. I praise your name, not just today,
yeah. I want to thank our streaming audience for being here with us today. We're here every Sabbath day at 12 o'clock hour. And if you come in person, I tell you, you can come and share with us in our Life Builders class, which start at the 11 o'clock hour. If not, you too can catch that on our website, www.pleasantplaceministries.org. But if you're in the Atlanta metropolitan area, and you may find your way down to the Riverdale area, just south of the city. We're here at 377 Valley Hill Road, Riverdale, Georgia. We'll be very excited and happy to see you. Amen? Amen, 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 amen. We're now in December, last month of the year. I tell you, this year seemed to just kind of zoom by, didn't it? Amen. We've had plenty of successes this year.
Yes, we have.
And we've had some what I call teachable moments.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. But through it all, I've learned to trust in Jesus.
Yes.
I've learned to trust in God. Yes. Through it all, the song was saying. Yes. Hallelujah. I come to know Him as Lord and Savior. I come to learn to depend on Him, to trust in Him. Amen. And I'm sure that is why we've had and enjoyed the successes that we've had this year. So now I'm preparing.
Yes.
I'm preparing now to go into another year.
Yes.
Amen. And I'm going to look back and I'm going to reassess what worked this year.
Yes.
Amen. And what didn't work out so great this
yes.
year. Amen. My successes will be a teaching moment. Amen. But my teachable moments,
yes.
my slip ups, my hiccups will be a teaching moments. Amen?
Amen.
So everything was positive. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so I'm looking forward. I'm encouraged going forward in this upcoming year to have greater successes, to reach greater territory. Amen. Hallelujah. But again, I say, but I want to reassess my life. Hallelujah. And lay aside all of those things, as Bible scripture tell us, the sin and the weight that was so easily. It's easy. Easy to beset us. We allow things into our lives that we should not allow.
Amen.
I heard somebody say earlier today, I heard one of the ministers going forth exhorting this morning and said, we are God's creation.
Yes.
Amen. And we should magnify His image. We should reflect His glory.
Amen.
Amen. His spirit.
Amen.
Yeah, yeah. I want somebody to walk up to me. I heard somebody else say, and say, I see the Christ. I heard that in Life Builders this morning. I see the God in you. Somebody never knew, did not know Him. I see the God in you.
Yes.
And that's what we want to reflect, the God.
Yes, God.
Amen.
Yes.
Yes, He sent Jesus here to be the light of the world. And so therefore we must, Paul says, imitate me as I imitate Christ. Hello, somebody. And so that's our assignment. So we cannot allow, listen, our lamps, listen, to have anything, any darkness in it, any way, shape or form. Goodness. I had a few projects that I wanted to get done on this past year, and I finally got them done. I'm in a position now to get it done. I waited till the end of the year to kind of get involved in it. And so if you hadn't finished a project of yours around the house or where it is or whatever it is, it's not too late. You still got about 25 days left. Get on it. Amen. Listen to me. It's a cinch by the inch. Because you just have to stay with it. You have to keep moving. I stepped out. We was getting ready to come to church this morning. My wife stepped out into the garage. That was one of my projects. And she says, you've really done a great job here in this garage. She says, listen, do you like to paint? The answer to that question is no. But guess what I found out? First of all, if you got good paint, one coat paint, good paint, amen, and it takes more than just good paint, then you have to have a good instrument, a good tool to apply it. I mean, you can have great paint and a terrible cheap brush, and you're going to get a subpar, amen, job. I'm telling you, it's not going to look that good. Listen, skill, technique, you'll develop that after your first coat of paint. Watch this. But that's the way the gospel is. That's how the gospel is entrusted to us. It's a good paint God has given us. Listen, in the gospel message. Now you can't taint it. Don't cut it. As word was said, don't add nothing to it. And don't take nothing from it. Amen. And skill will be acquired after you practice it. But I want to talk about the us part, the tool that administers. Listen, you can't have no dirt in your paintbrush. Amen. Amen. You can't have no stringy, flaky paintbrush. So today I want to talk about addressing our shortcomings. Is if we're getting ready to go into another new year, and we're getting ready, we're looking for success, amen, we need to address those things that hinders us, that beset us, amen, so easily. And I know I'm probably going to step on a few people's toes today, but I don't care. I'm almost 65. I got permission. Don't care. Amen. But because I hope it helps you. Not hurt you, but help. Amen. You. Uh-huh. I'm going to tell you something. I think the greatest people in the world, some of the greatest people in the world, are teachers. Are teachers. Amen? Yeah. There are teachers that can identify in children, watch this, shortcomings. And they know how to address those children in a manner for them to open up and share. Yes. Y'all still with me? Yes. The worst thing I think you can possibly do, amen, is to shame a student. I think those people are some of the worst people in the world. Amen. 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 And why I'm so passionate about that, because I was one. I don't know why, but when I grew up, I was so ashamed. I was so shy. I did growing up in the South and being of the darker persuasion. Amen. Although I'm fair skinned. Amen. You know, we were taught not to even address. We not even to look you in the eye when we talk. I inherited that. Listen, I was a good fully grown adult before I began to work on that, because I was introduced to somebody in my life that would talk to me and tell me and coach me how to get over that, how to address my shortcoming. Amen. Now when I talk to you, I look you dead in your face. Might step on your toe. Amen. Hallelujah. And speak with confidence. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. Not to hurt you or bring you down. None of that. Hey, but to build you up. Yeah. And that's what I'm looking for somebody. Amen. And I find them around here. We need to exercise that. We need to pull our children out. Amen. Carry them over into children's church. Identify their shortcomings. It'll come. Listen, but make them feel comfortable in sharing whatever it is that they're lacking, and then address it and learn how to address it. Amen? Amen. So that they can work on, that they can practice that, develop skills to overcome that, that they may progress. And we have to do it not only in our natural life, but in our spiritual life, because I'm telling you today, some of us got some problems. We got some hard issues we don't want to deal with. The Bible says that out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So you're going to tell on yourself. You're going to tell on yourself. Amen. But I need a few mature saints. Some of us are old, we're just not mature. We got birthdays in the Lord, but we didn't grow up. Amen. Paul had this issue, amen, with the church. He said, must I continue to, he put it like this, to give birth again until Christ be formed in you? What is he talking about? Until Christ, because you are not exhibiting the fruits of the Spirit. Nobody really likes to confront their own issues. It hurts.
Yeah, that's true. That's so true.
And we fight. Oftentimes, your greatest fight comes from somebody, listen, that's dealing with the same struggle.
Come on. Yeah, yeah.
But they see it exposed in you. They don't want to deal with it.
Yeah.
But come on, we got to deal with our own issues. Come on, before we go forward, we have to deal with our own issues. Before we go into the new year and claim new territory, hallelujah, for what if you're just going to mess it up? I know some folk that can tear up a church.
Come on. Tear it up, show.
They can quote scripture.
Come on.
They can speak in tongues. They can turn around three times and backflip. That they won't deal with their own hurt. They won't deal with the past, whatever it is that brought it about. Listen to me, ladies and gentlemen, we're all God's children. Say, we're all God's children. And all of us have some kind of issue. Well, let's deal with it and go forward. I would invite you to, if you can, turn with me to Chronicles, 1 Chronicles, the 4th chapter. We're going to read two verses. 1 Chronicles 4, 9 and 10. And most of you could probably quote this without ever even looking it up. This is the prayer of Jabez. The prayer of Jabez. Listen to it. Listen to what is said here. And let's step back a moment and let's kind of analyze it. 1 Chronicles 4 and 9. And Jabez was more honorable than his brethren. He was honorable.
Yes.
Word says he was honorable.
Yes.
I'm looking at honorable men and women before me today. Honorable. You're here. Honorable. Amen. But that was an issue in his life, and his mom spoke it. You see, the name Jabez means he makes sorrowful. He makes sorrowful. And apparently he has taken this to heart because he goes to God. He makes sorrowful. She said, I had him in my pain. He makes sorrowful. Anything, any of you study your scripture and you know when names was given in the Bible, amen, they just about stuck. It stuck. That's not so hard to believe because some of us was growing up and somebody may have called you out of your name or somebody may have spoke some negativity over your life and it stuck. It stuck because you just kept dwelling on it. Amen? And it stuck. See, whatever you focus on, just like a negative in a camera, just like that, whatever you focus on, that's generally what you'll produce. Amen? It stuck. And Jabez was more honorable than his brothers. He did this honorable thing in that his mother called his name Jabez, saying, because I bear him in sorrow. And Jabez called on the God of Israel, saying, oh, that thou wouldest bless me indeed. My goodness, and enlarge my coast. I want some new territory. I'm going into this new year. I want some new territory, but I'm going to need you to bless me. Hallelujah, that your hand be with me, and that thou wouldest keep me from what? Evil, sin. That so easily beset us. That it may not grieve. Listen to what he says. That it may not grieve me. That it won't hold me back. We getting ready to go into the new year. I'm on some new territory. We got to expand. Hallelujah. And the Bible goes on to say, and God granted him his request. Look. You know what his prayer was? It's me. It's me, oh Lord, standing in the need of prayer. Not my mother, not my brother. I don't have this to blame it on. Not my brother. Come on, somebody. But it's me that needs your help. It's spotlight on today. It's me. Hallelujah. My soul need to be revealed. Need to work on me. I need to get me. Hallelujah. Together. Because I'm the one, I'm the trouble. Hallelujah. That doesn't mean that you don't face adversarial situations. That don't mean, but it does tell you how to deal with it. The Bible says, vengeance is mine, saith the Lord. He didn't tell you to tell nobody off. He didn't tell you to read nobody their rights. Come on, somebody. Y'all still with me? Hallelujah. People that go to the aid of others, and that's what the Bible tells us too. He's that cover sin, right? Hallelujah. He he's that go to those that sin. Hallelujah. And covers. Listen, ministers, help can cover a multitude of sin. And you got that person that will go, that mature saint that will go and that will address the situation and say, look, sweetheart, I know what you're up against and I know what you're doing. Listen, we're going to have to deal with this. Let's talk about it. Let me see if how can I help you get through it out of this season in your life. And then you got that one that will go up there and they're going to read you your rights. Listen, and out in front of everybody, they want to expose you, not the sin. Those that come to cover, listen, it creates an environment to learn from the mistakes and grow. And then you have those that create an environment to bring upon shame and belittling. You punch me in my wound, I'm going to just cover it up all the more. But how many of you know that open wounds, has to, listen, be open so it can heal? That oxygen has to get to it and blood has to flow. Hallelujah. And then there are those that were just stifle and kill. Going into the new year, I'm going to tell you some things that should not be named among us, and one is gossiping. One more time. Gossiping, listen to this. Webster defined gossip as either a person who is habitually reveals personal or sensational facts as a rumor or report of an intimate nature. One of the biblical words used to mean a whisperer. They use it as a gossiper, a whisperer. Let me tell you, girl, let me tell you. Man, let me tell you this. In Romans, you will see it mentioned, and over in Corinthians, you see it mentioned. It points to intimate nature of material shared. Another word is busybodies. All up in my business. All up my business. I never understand why people spend so much time in other folks' business. Use that time for your own self. For your own self. For your own. I'm sure there's something around your house to be painted. Another word means to meddle in business which doesn't pertain to you. Amen. What does I have to do with you? Amen. Good or bad, what does I have to do with you? Amen. Doesn't add anything to your life. Doesn't take anything away from your life. Another word that come from the word meaning to babble, suggesting that gossip is empty, pointless talk, often not completely factual. Got to put it aside. James said, if any man think himself to be religious and cannot bridle his tongue, that man's religion is worthless. Amen?
Amen.
Another word translated malicious gossip, 1 Timothy and Titus, is the same word that is most often translated devil. Comes from a compound word meaning to throw something against someone. It ought to scare us to realize that when we participate in gossiping, we enter the very nature of the devil.
Wow. Amen.
God hates the gossip. Amen?
Amen.
It's the things we just don't take to heart.
Yeah, yeah.
Hallelujah. We're so casual with what we do, what we hear, what we do, and repeating things. Amen. And I'm telling you, it hinders our growth and our progress. You need to put it aside. Amen. Now, this is what I found out real good. If you want God to talk to you, humble yourself. Do you hear me? Humble yourself. Hallelujah. And ask God whatever it is that you need to know. Humble yourself. Sit before him. Amen. Find your quiet spot, humble God, and allow him to lead you and direct you. Amen. And you're on your way. So before we go into the new year, we need to clean up what we messed up. Come on, because we're starting it all over again. We need to clean up what we messed up as we start it all over again. And I'm getting ready. We want some new territory to gain some new territory. This I want to make some new force, some new relationships this year. Amen. Because I know that we need help. I'm going to say that one more time. We need help.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We need some more hands on deck. Hallelujah. I'm around a whole lot of people. I oftentimes, and it's not easy, people that come in and they can spot out the problems. Yeah, they got a gift for that. Spot out all the problems. Now I need them to send the ones with the gift that can help solve them. Amen. Hallelujah. That's got enough stress to let, but listen, but this is what I'm going to do. This is the part I want to play. This is the role in which I want to. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah.
Yes, yes.
So how are we going to go forward, right? Again, we're working on the brush. The paint is the gospel.
Yes.
We got the best paint. Come on, the paint. We got the paint. Come on.
Yes.
We're working on the brush. That's us.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Instruments of the gospel.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're cleaning the brush. We're tightening up the brush. Come on, somebody say, hey, Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary. Hallelujah. Come on. Prepare me. And then bless me to go to work.
Yes.
A paintbrush isn't any good unless you use it to paint. Unless you use it to paint. Now, we're getting ready again to go forward into the new year. I want some new territory. Listen, I get my paintbrush and get my paintbrushes together and everything. Now that they're getting cleaned out, and this and that, now we're going to sanctify. In other words, it's time to ordain some brushes. The Bible says, lay your hands on no man suddenly. Hallelujah, because some of us are novice. I'm having a problem trying to lay my, and if somebody talk about you, you flip out. Come on, we got to do better than that. Come on. First thing you know, when you made it in ministry, somebody going to talk about you. Or anything else for that matter. Come on. When they start to talk about you, when you start hearing, when somebody make a mistake and tell the rumor to you, they didn't even stay there long enough to find out who they were talking about. Mm-mm. Remember who called you. Remember who called you. Amen. And so this year, going forward, we're going to put some people in place. Hallelujah. And you're going to have to make up in your mind. Everybody that preached the gospel. And I don't care if you preach it from a guitar, or preach it from an organ, or preach it from a camera, or preach it from the greeter. Everybody that's part of ministry, you're going to have to make up in your mind. Yes. This is what I've been called to do. And this is what I'm going to do. Amen. It's like being the bus driver. I always told you, I never saw myself as no minister, no preacher, but at a church. But I said I wanted to be the bus driver. I'll be your best bus driver this ministry would ever have. I'll be the bus driver because I would get up in the morning when my shift goes on, I'll be there in the bus. Yeah. Amen. I start my route. I go to the bus stop. Listen, I'll start. Hallelujah. I am not responsible for who get on the bus or who get off the bus. Hello, somebody. I'm not skipping any avenues because I didn't see nobody go down the street. My job is to drive the bus. Yeah. Hallelujah. Perhaps one day he have somebody there that want to get on. Yeah. Amen? Amen? And that's what he chose me in his infinite wisdom. Before the foundation of the world, he says, look, there's Jerry. Jerry gonna drive the bus. I got somebody I can depend on to drive the bus. Yes. But he didn't just call my name. He called yours too. Amen. Amen. I got somebody that I know if I bless them, they gonna bless my work. They gonna bless. Amen. Hallelujah. He says, I give seed to the sowers. He's a sower. So I'm going to seed him up. Amen. I'm going to seed him up. He is a sower. I'm going to see different callings, different gifts, different callings, different gifts and different callings. Amen. And I thank him for it. And he says, you know what he says? And it's for the perfection of the church. Amen. Amen. So this year, let's get ready to go forward. Let's get ready to have our territory expanded. Hallelujah. And listen to me. Something else I want you got to get this. Success is not always measured by how many new people you signed on. Sometimes it's measured by how many you held on to, how many you sustained. Could it be God called you to be a waterer? Some planters Some come by in water. Hallelujah. But God gives the increase. Come on and clap your hand and praise Him. Now, I know that didn't make you shout or run around the church. Amen? Hallelujah. But I guarantee you, if you put that into practice this year, come on somebody, you are going to have a much more successful year, amen, than you did this past year. And all of us gotta clean it up. You want God to use you? You better clean it up. Amen? Hallelujah. You better clean it up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I just don't think He just continued to pour His Spirit in unclean vessels. He doesn't do that. Read your scripture. He doesn't clean you up. He give you what you need to work on self. Amen. Bible says gifts and callings. I'm finished, but Bible says gifts and callings comes without repentance. You know what I mean? There's a lot of folk got gifts and callings on their life, and they not living a nickel worth of nothing. And unfortunately, some of them are using their gifts and calling, amen, to enriching self. But in order to perfect, we're here to perfect the church. Hallelujah. That when Jesus returned, He's returning for His own. Christ, head of the body, the church. And I, for one, I stopped wanting to be in that number a long time ago. I, for one, am going to be in that number. Yes. Amen. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. An altar built, a table spread, a tree that grew, a life was spared. Between two thorns, justice was placed. Blood for the world, amazing grace. Oh, how I'm drawn to the cross alone, the place where mercy and sin atone, the place where my sins met therein. Everything changed there, the cross alone. New life begins there, the cross alone. A rugged piece of justice took a Christ that would give up His life in exchange for a world so lost to claim His name. Sing.
Oh, how I'm drawn to
the cross alone,
place of mercy
and my sin atone. There's a place in eternity where the love of God met humanity on a hill called Golgotha. He bled upon a tree, and there He made the sacrifice just for you and me. Oh, how I'm drawn to the place of mercy. It was the place,
where
all of my sins
left
therein. Because of Calvary, new life begins there. The cross, yes it did, yes it did. I know it, yes it did, yes it did. Now we want to sing a few hymns about the power of the cross, and I hope you help us sing it out there. Come on.
So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophy at last I lay it down, I lay them down. I will cling to the old rugged cross. Everything changed.
Song that I got saved on. I need everybody, wherever you're.